Hello everyone, it is me again. This time I'm going to do the 5th episode of Bug Hedge of Control, of my gameplay of Bug Hedge of Control. This time I'm gonna buy the new vehicle, the Unlimited BW, and I've decided, after thinking a bit about it, that I'm gonna buy this third one because I like how it looks a bit like an actual Volkswagen Beetle from the front. Like, yeah, you can see the shapes of a Volkswagen there. And it's also like, for example, one of the things I don't like is, for example, how ridiculously long this car looks, even though it's pretty much the same length. It's possibly the same fucking length, but yeah, it looks ridiculously long. And this one, well, it's very cute, and it's based after the new Volkswagen Beetle, and that's very original. I like it a lot, but yeah, I've used it several times here in other playthroughs of this game. So yeah, and for example, I don't know, between these two, I like this, for example, the shorter cabin, I also like it. So yeah, I'm gonna use this one. Oh yeah, now I can choose the fucking skin before buying it. Motherfucker. And I'm gonna possibly use it on this weird camo color. Yeah. Not that bad. I'm gonna purchase it. And upgrades, as I've told you, I'm gonna do only reliability related ones. The suspension. Yeah, I'm gonna do this one. And then cooling, I have two options, gotta choose the cheaper one. Yeah, because the best ones are pretty much perfect, like, it never blows up. So yeah, this is gonna be the car I'm going to use. Oh fuck, I forgot. I mean, maybe I could like tune it. The more damping you apply, then and the bias, I'm gonna do the same. Because I kinda liked it, how it worked out. I gotta change this, and this doesn't matter to me. So that's gonna be pretty much my car. I think I'm gonna do pretty much the same changes on all cars, because, I mean, while it's not perfect, it kinda works out. And yeah, let's see the Unlimited BW video. While my PS3 fucking freaks out. Okay, that turn is fucking cool, and that cameraman is fucking insane. Like, you know, I know that the car is pushing to the outside and all that, but yeah, that's crazy. Oh yeah, that's the one based on the new BW. Oh, by the way, these are all class 5 buggies of different kinds. Slightly different kinds, but yeah, pretty much the same class. And oh yeah, and already 2 rallies on here. I guess I'll try to squeeze it up in all just one video. So yeah, 3 leagues, 2 rallies, and a hill clean plus the fucking open class, which I'm not gonna do right now, so yeah. First off is the High Risers League, sponsored by Bluesy, which is gonna be 3 races. First one at Lone Rock in Lake Powell, Iron King Trail at Uyuni Salt Flats, and Crisscross at Kokono Island. And I'm gonna be racing against, okay, I think it's already 8 cars. Yeah, 8 cars already. Michelle Bragman, Ian McEwan, Holden Hayden-Ritter, George Seeley, Dave Bonner, Derek Douglas, and Armando Albanez. Oh yeah, oh that's gonna be cool. The Albanez car is the one of Who's Your Daddy energy drink. That's cool.
And for example, in this league there are only like, I think it's like 14 cars available. Or 15, I mean it's a pretty small number. It's gonna be quite possible that we are going to see repeated the same cars over and over again.
Much more common than before.
Because you know that happens.
And yeah, this is a pretty long loading time, for example. Come on, guys. Okay. There goes my beautiful little car. Maybe it's not little in Europe, but it's little when compared to what we are going to see later in the game. Cutting the turn a bit. Three wide on here. Bumping and grinding. Okay, yeah. They fucking pushed me out. So yeah, 8 cars. Still pretty short tracks. For example, this one is not as short, but yeah, other ones might be as short as the other ones. And yeah, that was a dive. That was a big fucking dive. And depending if I'm seeing like I don't have, you know, enough power or something, I might upgrade the car, but so far so good. Come on. Yes! Nah. Fucking up the banners. He's gonna push me out? No. Yeah, I made him take the jump. My line didn't have a jump. And another banner goes. So yeah, that's Armando Albanez with the Who's Your Daddy car. I find it hilarious that there's an energy drink called, or there was, an energy drink called Who's Your Daddy. But yeah, it's the name of the fucking brand. That was a good pass! So yeah, those were a nice couple of minutes of racing. Now it's just driving. Come on. Sometimes I really struggle for traction. Yeah, using fifth gear to, you know, don't punish the car much. I mean, if you're keeping momentum, you can keep the same speed basically all race long. Especially in some tracks. Like, for example, maybe I'm not being the fastest guy around. And for example, I'm gonna have to downshift for this part because, you know, this part is a lot tighter. And there's also the chicane after this next straight. But yeah, you can do pretty much the whole track in 1 year without a problem. Okay, I'm winning by a lot. Armando just died. He probably was driving way too hard. They have problems. They have mechanical problems as much as the player does in this game. That was a good clean win.
Okay, I'm gonna take notes of the scoring system because it's gonna be different. Oh, by the way, the sponsors do not carry between classes. It's kind of a shame, to be honest. I don't like that. And next, oh, okay, it's the same, but with 40 points for the eighth place.
So it was Albanez, Bonner, Douglas, Heitreiter, Bragman, Silly, and McEwen. So yeah, next race at Iron King Trail. So you, right now I do not need 170 points to win to secure the championship, but I need 180 because, you know, 40 points for the last place. And that actually makes it a bit more interesting. I mean, it's a bit harder to secure the championship. I mean, it's just a bit harder, I mean, it's not much. Yeah. Whatever floats your boat. And yeah, not your boat, but your boat. Okay. What the fuck? My car forgot to turn. That was some understeer. Okay, McEwen, what the fuck? I made you overtake a few guys, do not complain, motherfucker! And for some reason I'm third? Yeah, I'm third, what the fuck? Okay, that's not cool. Oh, and by the way, the motherfucker was a girl. It's Michelle. And by the way, I pulled a very cool path right there. Come on. I have to make quite the comeback if I want to win. Oh, by the way, the spare tire can be lost, and that's a huge problem in the bigger tracks. Oh, there's a guy pitting, and that can be a very big problem on both the longer tracks and on the rally, and of course the rallies. And on the hill cleans, it means basically defeat. You're not gonna win that race because, you know, if you get a puncture on a hill clean, you only have your own spare tires. I mean, you cannot go to the hot pits because there are none. Okay, and for some reason I'm second. Albanez faded out quite quickly. Sorry, god damn it. It's not entirely my fault. Sorry. Didn't mean it. I don't like this turn, like this right hand hairpin. Like, it really throws you out. Yeah, drifting. I mean, I know it's not drifting, but you know what I mean. Oh god, oh my goodness, that was close. Sometimes it's better to, when you get your car onto wheels, sometimes it's just better to just put the wheels straight and let's hope for the best. Because you can really fuck it up at times. And yeah, I won. That was weird. I mean, it was more of a weird race because, I mean, I got to like third, then I went to eighth. Yeah, I was last. And then I started climbing back to like 4th or 3rd, and I overtook Albanez in a very easy way, and then I made a mistake and pushed Derek Douglas out of the track. Seriously, it was a mistake. Believe me, please. So yeah, right now I'm gonna have to finish third to secure the championship if it's Albanez leading. Yeah. I mean, unless Albanez is out of the first place, I need to finish on the podium. And if he finishes second, I can finish as much as like fifth, which is kinda good for me. And if he doesn't finish on the podium, I have the championship automatically, whatever he does. I don't care. Yeah, it's a matter of finishing on the podium for me. I do not really have to win. I mean, winning is cool and I get a lot of money, but yeah, it's not all about winning. Oh yeah, Chris Cross. This is a multi-race line kind of track. It can be extremely confusing. Choosing the right racing line is extremely, extremely important. And yeah, you can be legal, like the AI, and keep whatever line you choose, or be a dirty cheat. Okay, that was a mistake by Douglas. That was weird, very weird. And I didn't touch him, I swear I didn't touch him. So yeah, choosing the good racing line is very important. I know the good lines for here. Except for this, this is very confusing to me. Because I've done everything. Like, I've won using the outside lane, I've won using the inside lane. I don't know, for me it's not multi-line, but yeah, for the AI it is, and well, it's usually good for me. Because they fuck it up at some point. Even if I'm keeping it, by the way, I'm keeping it perfectly legal. I haven't done anything weird. I'm gonna do the shorter line. Okay, and it's the win. Yeah! Oh no, fuck, it's 3 laps. Yeah, you can also use this line. It's a bit more straightforward than the one on the right, but it rises a bit more, so it's not that good on the first lap. It's actually very complex. Okay, that was a mistake. God damn it! God damn it! Okay. Also, yeah, the outside lane has the fucking pits. That's cool, I guess. So yeah, I do not really know which one is the faster one. I mean, it's kind of hard to see the difference. I mean, I can guess that the inside one is better because, you know, it doesn't throw you up high on the first hill or anything like that, but yeah, I don't know. The problem is the second part. The first part is very easy to see which one is the fastest line. So yeah, that was a very, very easy win. Mostly because, you know, Derek Douglas should have been my main competitor, but he fucking flew off the track. So yeah, there's that. And that was a clean sweep. 3 out of 3. And Armando finished like... ooh. He finished like 4th. Yeah, he finished 4th. Yeah, that was pretty easy. Precept Motorsports, which is an amateur team, that's why it has 4 numbers. Hewitt Racing, another amateur team, Hammer Down Racing, which is from the class before, that's a Baja bag, not an unlimited. And that's it. So yeah, see you next time for the next league of the unlimited Volkswagen class, which is basically class 5 buggies all the way.
And we'll see how it goes on the next episode. Bye bye!